Hey, once again, everyone, and welcome. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can expose variables inside of our blueprints as 3D widgets that we can then use and modify and manipulate inside of our viewport here. So let's go ahead and get started. We are using the Blueprint First Person Template Project with starter content enabled. And let's create a brand new blueprint. Gonna hop over to the modes panel over here under the basic tab. Just gonna drag an empty actor into our scene here. And gonna add some components to it in the details panel. First thing I'm gonna add is a scene component, just so we can manipulate the transform. And just gonna call it the root. And gonna add one more component, gonna add a static mesh, like so. And that name is fine. In the details panel under static mesh, gonna click this none dropdown and search for cube. And we're gonna use a shape cube for this particular blueprint that we will create. So let's create a blueprint out of it, actually. Gonna click the Blueprint Add Script button, and let's just call it the Cube Blueprint. Create Blueprint. Looks good to me. Created the brand new blueprint in the content browser and popped open a new tab for me. Just gonna select that. So there is our static mesh component inside the viewport here. Gonna hop over to the event graph, actually, and gonna right-click and drag these default nodes out of the way. And the first thing that we're going to do is create a brand new variable. So let's hop over to the My Blueprint panel over here, click the Add Variable button. Let's call this the Sizer variable. Over in the Details panel, I'm going to change the variable type to a vector, and we're going to make it editable. Now, if you recall, making a variable publicly editable, if we compile and hop into the editor here, will allow you to see that variable and change it inside the Details panel, which is cool. But there is one neat little trick. If you go back to the cube blueprint, the show 3D widget, if you go ahead and check that box and compile and hop back to the level, now you can see that we have a 3D representation of this variable inside of our level here. So how can we use this? See how we can, if we select it, first of all, if we select it, we can now move it around in relation to our blueprints location. So it is able to move independently of our blueprint. So how can we use this actually? Let's go ahead and find out. Let's go up to the cube blueprint again, and let's go to the construction script actually. And what we're going to do is hold control and drag in our sizer here. And what we're going to do now is drag off of the sizer, and we are going to say break vector. We're going to break this vector into x, y, and z coordinates. And we know that the size of our cube is 100 units. So what we're going to do is drag off the Z, and let's search for float divided by float. Yeah, that's what we want. Float divided by float. And we're going to plug in 100 here. And the next thing that we'll do is control and drag in our static mesh. Going to drag off our static mesh here, and we're going to set scale 3D. Set relative scale. Going to connect to the construction script like so, and drag off of our vector here, and create make vector actually. So that's going to give us x, y, and z. Now the x and y, we're going to keep that at 1, but the z, because we want to scale our box up and down, we're going to plug in this here like so. So let's compile and save. You see the construction script has been fired because we compiled. If we hop back into the level, look at our little cube. It's flattened out. But there's our box or our sizer there. Let's move it back. Actually, moving it back is not going to matter because we didn't adjust the X and Y. But the Z, however, if I move it up, now we can move our cube and resize our cube right here in the viewport, like so. So how can we use this to our advantage? If we wanted to create some kind of procedural content, we could have some, like a fence, for example. We could have a fence spawn at each of the location of our 3D widget here to create a fence procedurally, or a bunch of other things that you could do. You can kind of experiment and see what works best for you. But that is how you expose variables and expose the 3D widget inside Blueprints. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you next time.